Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com is my website. I wrote many articles on SAP basis administration in this website. Many people got benefited from those articles. My name is Mr. Raj. I am SAP basis NetWeaver international trainer. I have trained students in more than 50 countries. In this video, I'll show you daily tasks of SAP basis administrators. That means regular usage of transaction codes, common transaction codes. I'll show you. So this is the SAP system. First T code I'll show you is SM04. It will display the user list, means who are all the users logged on to the instance. It will show only one user is logged into the system, that's why it is showing only one. But suppose if you have logged into the same system using other user account, it will show that user account separately. So let us check the user list. Click on the refresh button so that it will show different users logged into the system. This is 000 is session manager only. This is not yet logged in. And this one is logged in. This one is logged in. DDI is user and SAP user. Okay, that is about SM04. It will show the user list of the instance which you have logged in. Means the users logged into the instance, it will show the list of all the users. And there is another T code called AL08. It will show the list of users logged onto all the instances in the SAP system. So this particular SAP system has only one instance, that's why it is showing only one instance information. Okay, here DDIC is the user account, SAP user is the user account. So there are different sessions. I will close all those sessions so that you can look at the information properly. Click on the refresh so that sessions are closed. Only three sessions are available. All sessions are 001. Okay, so like this. Now next transaction code is SM51. SM51 displays the different instances within the SAP system. Right now only one instance is available, that's why it is showing only one instance. Okay, if you have different instances like this, for suppose this system has two instances, it will show two different servers. Like right now it is showing as NW7EHP1_DEV_00. It would have shown NW7EHP1_DEV_01. Means the number of instance information will be displayed here. Like this, each instance, what are all the services, what are the work processes are available also, it will show in this particular column. Okay, so that is about SM51. It will display the servers, SAP servers. Within the SAP system, you can have many instances. It is also called SAP application server. First application server is called central instance. Remaining all the instances are called dialog instances. If you have one central instance and 10 dialog instances, it will show all those 11 instances here. One central instance and remaining 10 dialog instances. So that is the purpose of SM51. You can display the application server using SM51. Next T code is SM37. SM37 is for displaying the background job information. Means it will show all the jobs which are all running in the background. Okay, select the schedule, click on the execute button, and it will show the different types of jobs which are already running and already scheduled and already finished. If it is running, the running status also it will show. So that is about SM37 T code. There are separate classes for all these T codes, but in this particular video, I wanted to show you different T codes which you will use regularly. Okay, so Next T code is SM50. SM50, you must be aware of. SM50 is work process VRU. It will display all the work processes are available in this particular system, in this particular instance. Okay, if you want to look at different, like all the work processes of all instances, SM66 is the T code. SM66 is the T code. So it will show all the work processes available in the all instances, like select process. If you choose only dialog and status wait, click on the continue so that it will display all the dialog work processes of all the instances. Right now only one instance is available. It is showing only one instance's information. If this particular SAP system consists of more than one instance, it will show all the dialog work processes of all the instances using this SM66 T code. That's why it is called global work process VRU. So next T code is SM12. SM12 is for maintaining logs. Means if you are performing some operation in the SAP system, that particular record will be locked. Means no other user can modify the same data. Okay, so that just I will show you how it is done. Like the lock entry is not there at all here. Just for to get the entry, what I will do is just I'll go to another session. So I am in another session. So this is 001 and 001 and user account is DDIC. Okay, from here SU01 and let me change something about my particular user. SAP user is the user account which I have used here to log in. So this is the SAP user, and what I am trying to do here is that I want to change something here. When I click on the change button from this application toolbar, what will happen? It will enter the lock inside the lock table. Means if you click on the refresh button, the lock information should be displayed here. So no lock entries found. I am in 001, here also in 001. It is the 001 and this is also 001 client. Within the same client I am doing this experiment, so that it should show the details about lock. Go back and okay, not username star, click on the list button. So like this it will show the information about that particular lock entry. Means DDIC user is performing the modification of SAP user, that's why this particular DDIC has the lock to modify that particular entry. So simultaneously no two users can modify any of the record in the database. So that is the main purpose of SM12 T code. SM12 T code is for managing lock entries. Okay, so that is, this particular job will be done by the NQ work process. NQ work process will be available only in the central instance. You can look at that information using again SM51 T code. SM51 will display that type of work process. This is NQ work process. Not only SM51, SM50 also will shows the NQ work process. This is the NQ work process. Because this is central instance, that's why NQ work process is there. Dialog instance will not have the NQ work process. So whole entire SAP system will have only one NQ work process which will handle the lock table. To look at lock table, what is the T code? SM12 is the T code. SM12 is the T code. It will display the information. So like this, here instead of SAP user, if you put star, it will show the lock entries of all user accounts. So that is the purpose of SM12. Next T code is SU01. Anyway, just now you have seen what is the purpose of SU01? User maintenance means SU01 will be used for the user administration. Entire user administration can be done using the SU01. Next is SM13. SM13 is for update administration. If something is updating in the SAP system, it will show all the updates, what are all the updates are available in the system. Okay, from here you can do the update administration. That is the purpose of SM13 T code. Okay, next T code is SM21. SM21 is used for displaying system log, means it is just like event viewer. It will read the system log, what are all the activities are performing are happening in the system. It will display like this. Okay, all the events will be displayed in this SM21 T code. Okay, next T code is SM02. SM02 is the T code for sending system messages. System messages means you can send the message to all the logged in users. If the user is not logged in also, when the user logs into the system, he will get that particular message. Okay, just let us create the system message from here using system create button and welcome to our company. We have scheduled maintenance during some time, we can specify. Okay, so you can choose the server name also from here. Only one server is available right now, so you can choose the server name and client. You can choose the client, that particular client users in the that particular client only will get the message of this particular message. Okay, so click on the save button. Okay, system message is added. Now let us go to other session. Okay, as soon as I interact with the session, I should get the message like this: SAP user, welcome to our company, we have scheduled a maintenance. Like this, every user who logged on to the SAP system already will get the information instantly when they interact with the system, or the users who logs into the system will get the message. So that is the purpose of SM02 T code. So next T code is RZ20. RZ20 is the central monitoring purpose. These are all the monitors available. From here you can configure the monitors, means you can create the monitor set and monitors. There is a separate video, there are separate videos available on system monitoring, SAP system monitoring. You can watch those videos to understand more about CCMS monitors, means computing center management system it is. So you can monitor your entire SAP system from the single location. So that is the purpose of RZ20 T code. So these are all the common T codes which will be useful for the SAP basis administration, and frequently you will use all these T codes. It is better to remember all the T codes properly, so that it will be very helpful for you to answer your interview questions, or you can it will be helpful for your system administration, SAP system administration. I hope you understood the daily tasks of SAP basis administration in this video. Thanks for watching. You can ask me any questions or doubts in my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, or you can also leave your comments under this video in the YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.